nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 1.6. We're continuing on the topic of 2D photonic crystals, and now we're going to focus more specifically on calculating band gaps. And so recall that from the last lecture, we actually wrote down the photonic crystal master equation, or Maxwell's master equation, which is this first equation here. And then by representing the whole system in Fourier space, and we were able to transform the operator in the upper left into basically a large matrix, which multiplies a column vector HGG minus G prime, which basically describes the Fourier components of the magnetic field, or the H field. And this is implemented numerically in MIT photonic bands. And so in order to get a better intuition for what's happening in 2D photonic crystal band structures, we can actually go back to the 1D photonic crystal case and then use that to understand more clearly what was happening in 2D. And so the way that we're going to look at it is actually, this is our 2D photonic crystal here, and we assume that we have both high and low dielectric regions. And then we're going to basically split this up at a given incident angle into stripes. And then we're going to say that each stripe has a different effective index. Okay. And because the effective indices are different in those two regions, it almost looks like a 1D distributed Bragg reflector with alternating high and low dielectric layers. And so if we have a frequency that meets the Bragg condition, so basically that the central frequency is equal to pi c over the period times the average refractive index, n average, which is the average of the effective media n1 and n2. So of course, it's not actually a physically observed index, but it's somewhere in intermediate in most cases. Then presuming that this a2 is less than our a1 in different angle, then we'd have also omega 1 is less than omega 2. Okay, and so then this kind of shows how you can have a range of band gaps, like a different angle. So basically, like each k vector, which has a certain angle and certain effective periodicity, gives rise to these certain band gaps. And you can see how these band gaps are varying. And so this structure would be said perhaps to have at least a partial photonic band gap. And so here's like a more clear description. So here you basically see you have this omega 1 at a particular incident k vector, which might be just above 0. And then you have another band gap here at a larger k vector. However, if you actually have a broad enough bandwidth for the reflection, and remember distributed Bragg reflector, that would be mainly controlled by the refractive index contrast, then you can actually have a gap that extends over both the first direction and then the second direction. And so that's illustrated in yellow as an omnidirectional band gap. And so now if we look at a real photonic crystal structure and calculation from MIT photonic bands, or MPB, then we can actually say that for a triangular lattice type structure of holes in a high dielectric material, so call it triangular lattice of air holes, then we have, first of all, a Brillouin zone that looks like this hexagon here, irreducible Brillouin zone that looks like 1/12, basically this triangle in kind of the upper right-hand corner. And then even though we have slightly different band gaps for both polarizations, there's enough overlap between the band gaps at different angles, so represented by these different k vectors, and both polarizations, so that you get like a full 2D photonic band gap. And so that's what's illustrated in yellow. And so you can see on the right-hand side that this doesn't necessarily happen for just an arbitrary geometry, but you have different band gaps, primarily like at the low radius end. So basically where you have predominantly high dielectric for the TE. And then when you have like predominantly air, so the radius is approaching 1/2, which is basically like, means that all the circles are starting to overlap means that you have more of a TM band gap. But then at some points in between, about 0.4 to 0.5, then you have this yellow region where you actually have reflection both of TE and TM waves. In the next lecture, we'll talk in more detail about other calculations that we can perform on 2D and 3D band structures.